New at 6, we've seen a number of high-profile carjackings lately, and we want to help you protect yourself. Today, we partnered with a local self-defense school to show you how to reduce your chances of becoming a victim and ways to respond in a worst-case scenario.
Give me a wallet!
Gun, gun, gun! He's got a gun! He's got a gun!
Steve Solzi, owner of Extreme Krav Maga in Fenton, has been teaching self-defense tactics like this for nearly a decade.
We try to train as realistic as we can.
One of his team's specialties is carjacking scenarios, and more importantly, how to avoid them.
Being aware, having a plan, and then being able to execute that plan.
Solzi says avoiding a carjacking starts before you get out of your car, with steps like parking in a well-lit area and thinking about your surroundings.
If it is a not a great area, you know, maybe skip that place.
When you're headed back to your car, walk with someone else. If you're alone, keep your eyes open for anyone who looks suspicious.
Build that routine into locking your doors, you know. Again, just kind of checking your mirrors, checking around you, check your back seat.
And here's something many of us should consider. Sitting in your car and focusing on your phone makes you an easy target.
That text or that phone call or whatever can wait.
But even if you take the right precautions, bad things can still happen. That's why Solzi says being prepared is critical.
You're actually going to fall to your lowest level of training. And we tell people we want that lowest level of training to be extremely high.
So what do you do? If you find yourself looking down the barrel of a carjacker's gun, handing over your keys is one option. And as Solzi shows us, there are others.
Get out of the car right now.
Whoa,
get out of the
whoa,
car.
Whoa, easy,
out
man.
Out of the car.
Gun, gun, gun. He's got a gun. Get back. Show me your hands. Don't move.
I'm going to be redirecting away from me, locking my arm. My second hand's coming up behind because I know his natural reaction is going to be to pull back. So what I'm thinking about doing is controlling that gun with two hands. I'm going to redirect the barrel in towards him, and I'm going to use the threshold here to kind of break down towards his wrist. Taking the gun away, tapping, racking, clearing any malfunction, and then giving him orders to back away, show his hands, so that I can secure my vehicle.
Solzi says each situation is different, and the decision whether to fight back like that is up to you. But if you're going to defend yourself, he says you need to know how to do it, and his business offers many self-defense classes throughout the year.